this grave hour, perhaps the most fateful in our history, I sent to the every household of my peoples, both at home and overseas, spoken with the same depths of feeling for each one of you, as if I were able to cross your threshold and speak to you myself.
As you may have noticed, it was the beginning of King George VI's speech, which turned him from shy, nervous monarch into truly inspiring leader. So, speech matters. It's Teaching Teens again, and today we will discuss how to make your student speech king's speech. So, let's go! The first thing to teach is structure. So, if you prepare students for any exam, the task itself implies certain structure. So, today let's focus on the Russian EGE. To tell the truth, I'd like to omit the first and the second tasks, because I trust in you and your abilities to teach 16 years old to read and ask questions. So, come on, let's move on. So, the third and the fourth tasks. The examinee has a minute and a half to prepare and 2 minutes to speak. Even a minute will be enough to give a proper talk in case you have a structure. The structure consists of clichés, linking words, and answers to questions. In case you are too busy or too lazy, you can just show the following chapter of our video to your students.
Nice.
We always begin with a common phrase, then suppress creativity and sincerity to follow exam requirements. You gotta say this. Next step, answer the question where and when the photo was taken. Moving on, the question is what or who is in the photo and what is happening. Describe the foreground, what's going on there, and give details. Don't forget to tell where you are in the picture. Then describe the background. Moving on, the question is why you keep this photo in your album. That's a lovely example, but you can customize it the way you want. The next question is why you decided to show this picture to your friend. And finish the speech with the phrase, "That's all I wanted to say. It is essential." Again, let's begin with the common phrase. Briefly describe each picture in a couple of sentences, answering who, what, where, and don't forget to use present continuous. Talking about similarities, try to name at least 3 of them. Talking about differences, at least 2 are essential to get maximum points. Before the conclusion, express your own attitude to the subject. Actually, it is the main part of your answer. In case you don't know what to say, feel free to be general and describe your preferences. And finally, summarize everything once again. The next thing to practice while preparing for speaking is vocabulary.
Anyway, children, let's start off with some vocabulary.
It's great to have a rich one, but it takes effort to nail the skill. The algorithm is rather simple. Let your student write his or her own speech, check the grammar, and look for synonyms. Actually, we all know about these 2 lovely services, which all students could use for self-study and practice. For example, thesaurus.com is web's #1 synonym search engine. It provides you with precise examples and access to almost unlimited base of linguistic wisdom. Moreover, App Store and Google Play are stuffed with games and apps made to enrich your students' vocabulary. Initially, the best way to boost your students' speaking skills is to practice a lot.
Practice, practice, practice!
Conduct discussions, create a friendly and sincere atmosphere so that your students do not feel shy and unconfident. That's all for today. Subscribe to our channel, share our videos, and join our great team. Good luck and have fun!